When I started to think of the film, I knew how I wanted the film to be. Like, I knew I can feel the rhythm, the how the images should flow, the sound, even the smell of the film. But I didn't know how to make it. And I had to learn how to make the film while I was making the film itself. So it was a kind of a self-reflective, self-educational process. Because back to my question of how to capture the soul of a city inside a film, I realized, like, I remember in the beginning, I was like looking at the footage and I was like so frustrated and angry and upset every time I look at the rushes after the shooting, and I felt it has the same monotonous that I hate in cinema. And I was looking for something more vibrant and more real. I feel Cairo has this amazing mixture of tenderness and roughness. It's a very tough city, but also it's so kind. And I always thought of a film as a mixture, as a flow or a dance between roughness and elegancy. This is how I wanted the film to be. And then I remember that at one point I was in a discussion with my DOP, with the director of photography, who is, by the way, the Lebanese guy in the film, Basim.
Basim, right?
Yes. Yeah. And I was so, like, and we had also Salah Marai, who is the art director, and he was my professor, like, when I was a student. And then he said something. He said, if you want to film Cairo, you need to surrender to it. And I think this thing is like, it opened a door for us. And I learned through this process that actually we can't capture the soul of the city unless we allow the city to be itself. And it's a very fine line between following the film or make the film following you. It's actually, I realized that it's also about like dealing with your ego. Because when you go to the set, I decided to not to give a city a space. Because if you are looking for this magic, then you need to allow this magic to happen. And this magic will not happen until you give it this time and this freedom. And I always say this thing to my students. I say to them, when you do a feature film, you are like a farmer. You water your seeds, and you take care of your plant while it's growing every day. Your work is dependent on being patient and very careful with the love that you give to this plant that will come to you, and then you will have a beautiful tree and a delicious fruit. But when you do a documentary, you are like a fisherman. You go to the sea, you cast your net, and you hope that the sea is so generous and it will give you some fish. But if you don't trust the sea won't give you anything. So part of your work is to trust the sea. And in this film, I was trying to find the right balance between being a farmer and being a fisherman. So in a way, I was, for example, stopping myself of cutting the scene in my head before I go to the set. Because, and this is against everything I learned in cinema. Because always they are saying, you know, cinema is a very expensive process, so you have to be very accurate and you have to prepare everything. Because you don't want to waste time and you want to film everything on time. But also on the other side, when you have an image, you don't see anything else. But if you go and let the city inspire you, then you see more. And then there are things that, like we, like think for example of the scene of the football match. These people are the real audience, the real football fans. And there are moments that is not possible to reconstruct it the way it is. And that was the challenge.